Hey everybody, welcome to Absolutely Marvel in DC. It's just me today. I'm gonna talk about Supergirl, but the reason it's just me is because Sal doesn't watch any CW shows. Dan doesn't watch Supergirl. Benny is gonna join me next week, probably, but he didn't have time for Supergirl this week. So I figured I would just talk about it real quick. I haven't looked into like the specifics of the goings on of Supergirl's production schedule, but I'm pretty sure this episode, which is season 6 episode 1, is actually season 5 episode finale, because this is like absolutely a finale and it's not good. Just overall, I think I'll say real quick my thoughts on all of like season 5 and season 5's plot, which is mostly like there's this lady who is creating a VR simulation, and Lex Luthor is trying to use it to take over the world, and also Lena is doing mind control now, but she feels bad about it later, so she stops doing the mind control. It's not great. Also, Brainiac is, like, evil now, but he's only doing it because if he doesn't, then the world will end or something. He helped Lex, but he's still in love with Dreamer. They're cute. That's fine. I just think, like, in general, this episode was kind of rough. Supergirl has always had an issue with writing, and just its problems kind of boil down to just, like, weird plot decisions or the writing kind of being hokier than the other shows, which is a lot to say, but is kind of the truth, which is a shame, but, you know, it is what it is. I do still think Melissa Benoist is a good Supergirl, but they're just, like, I don't know. Like, Martian Manhunter is interesting, and there's some interesting characters, but this show is getting to the point that the other shows have gotten to where there's just a lot of characters going around, and especially in this show where everyone pretty much is a superhero. Like, even Alex is now a superhero. Sentinel is her new name. Like, there's just no room for all of these characters, and they haven't really had, like, an interesting plot in a while. They gave Lex superpowers this episode, but now he's like a goody two-shoes because Lena turned him and her mom into good people with Myriad, her mind control device, right before she turned it into Supergirl and company, which maybe Lena will become a superhero next season, or I guess the rest of this season, which I know this is the final season of this show, which makes sense. You know, you hate to see the two female-led CW shows, Batwoman and Supergirl, be canceled, but they're both bad. To be fair, I haven't watched anything past, like, episode 9 of season 1 of Batwoman, but it takes a lot for me to not watch a show, and that show made me not watch it. I made a video about it on my personal channel. Check that out. Anyway, yeah, Supergirl. I hope that they use the rest of this season, who knows what they're doing for actual season 6, but I hope they use the rest of it to sort of pare down the cast like Flash is doing right now, and get, like, I guess one final good Lex season, or maybe they're writing Lex off and it's going to be a new villain. I don't know. I feel like this should be their victory lap, even though they're getting canceled. They should just take it as a final goodbye, bring back all the stuff in the Supergirl mythos. They can't really, like, explain a lot of the crisis stuff because it's, that would be a lot of setup, I guess, and that might make people interested in the show again, and I guess you would want that, so you could bring the show back, but it's probably not coming back, so maybe don't do that. I don't know. I think Batwoman is, like, they're bringing Kate Kane back, just cast as a different person, which is strange, but that makes sense for a final season, that you would bring back season 1 elements. So who knows, maybe we'll get like the Lightning Woman from season 1, or some of the Kryptonians from like the Phantom Zone or whatever. Oh, speaking of the Phantom Zone, Supergirl's in the Phantom Zone now. That's like the cliffhanger, is Lex sends her to the Phantom Zone before he gets schnocked out by someone. I don't know what they're going to do with that. They could easily do some kind of time skip thing where she's been in there for a while and she comes out, like, really cool, like, has, like, armor on and like, dirt on her face, and she has, like, a side part cut in. That'd be dope, actually. Like, Gotham City Garage-style Supergirl That'd be kind of awesome. Maybe do that. Or maybe they'll just rescue her in the next episode. And, like, no time has passed, but, like, a new villain comes... Maybe Rogal Zar comes out of the Phantom Zone with her, and she has to fight Rogal Zar. Anyway, I don't really have much else to say about Supergirl. Not a whole lot happened in this episode, honestly. It was just a big, like, fight. Lex got the god's powers, and then he didn't. And Supergirl got sent to the Phantom Zone, and Alex is now called Sentinel. And she's... she's worried because she's got to tell her girlfriend that she's a superhero, but nobody cares about that character, so. Anyway, just a short little recap, just to start off our Supergirl discussions, since this is going to be the show for the next few weeks. Benny will probably join me next week. I'm sure he'll have some choice words. That'll probably be a more interesting thing, because I think that's the actual premiere of season 6, unless there's, like, one more episode of season 5, but I doubt it, because this really did feel like a finale. But we'll see. I like being left in the dark. And I hope you do too. Because I'm not Googling anything. Anyway, thanks for watching. Check back next week. Benny will be here. And for more discussions and videos and stuff about all things Marvel and DC and sometimes other things. But mostly, it's absolutely Marvel and DC. See what I did there? Anyway, see you later!